which I think is very, very silly and unresponsible. Which I think is very, very silly. That you will have many silly problems. Unbelievable, you lost the whole machine. Hello everyone, this is Jally. Why there are so much difference about the selling price of laser welding machines? So they probably choose the brands or the machine according to the advertisements or the brands on the internet. The configuration or the brand of the laser, brand of the chiller, and looks very similar or even exactly the same, but the prices are very different. We want to show you the real difference of two kinds laser welders. They look exactly the same with the same brand of laser and the same brand of chiller, same brand of welding head. Well, the price is very different. Let's go and check what's the difference. As you know, Chinese laser welders or Chinese laser machines have become more and more popular in the world. And many people start choosing laser welders or laser machines from China. Well, for most medium-sized or those end users that is not very economical for coming to China to choose a laser machine. Some customers, they buy cheap machines, some they buy not so cheap, but when they receive the machine, the quality is not satisfying. So that's the reason for today we make this video. Today we prepare two machines to compare in real. This one is a lower price, less quality machine, and this one is a higher price, higher quality machine. So first, we check the eyes. The looking, the appearance of these two machines. Very apparently, this one is cheaper and this one is more expensive because from the chiller, you can see it's completely different. This chiller, you can see that this one has more metal inside, so it's much heavier. And this one almost cancels all the metal part. In the past, this tank for the cooling water was made of steel. Now it's all plastic. And there is cover, metal cover for the turbines and things, for the copper. Well, this one, no. And even the thickness of these cabinets are different. This one is thicker and this one is thinner. And even, you probably don't know that the quality of this metal is different. And this one is the, because for my steel, they have different standards or the coat of the material. And this one is much cheaper, so it's very easy distortion, like this one. This cover should be completely sealed here, so no dust will go in for the control board. Well, because it has distortion, so this one cannot be assembled as the joints. So there are many, you know, details. If you try to control the cost in an unreasonable way, that you will have many silly problems during the operations. For the bottoms, and this one, you know, when you open the door, this is, you know, everything not really properly positioned. Well, this one is very nice positioned, all metal covered. So, you know, it's a painful thing that when you notice that things made in China has been improved in this way. You know, actually we should improve in another way that, of course, saving the cost for the customer is very precious and valuable work. But when you do things like this, you just simply cancel everything to make it cheaper, and you don't care that this canceling will cause what kind of problems in the future, which I think is very, very silly and unresponsible. In the next part, we introduce that this chiller temperature controlling is not connected with the welding gun board. So which means that you don't have the temperature protection. So you will easily burn or heating up the protective windows, the focus lens, and then you cause problems for the welding gun. And you then, maybe the laser working in high temperature will have the temperature alarms, you will have the problem for the laser. So, which in a logical way you think that you save some penny in this chiller, Well, you cause more expensive problems for the laser source and welding gun, which I think is very, very silly. Okay, now we go and check the inside wiring part, which is the, besides the mechanical configuration, then this electrical wiring diagram and how you're wiring this machine. So first, we judge from the overall, we see that this machine is very simple, not much wirings and not really very neat and not many signals, which means that this machine, if you have an electrical engineer to do the wiring of this machine, probably he can finish 4 units per day. Well, for this one, you see that there are more than 200 points to joint and wiring, so we need more working hours for electrical engineer, which means higher cost. And every wire, they have the recognition, the numbers, so you need to first taping it and then join it, which is, I like this machine, it's very nice. And second part, all the electrical part here using a Chinese brand, Zinc, and it's a local Chinese, it's not bad, but cheaper. And not sure if it's the high level part or, fake part or something. Okay. But for this machine, all use cylinder, which is from Germany, and is bigger. And of course, it's more expensive, every part, including the main switch and including the power switch inside. So the third point we can see, well, in this machine, we have a current filter. Well, in many countries that, well, the electrical construction is not so stable, when you input the electricity, the current may be not very clean. You have the wavings or noise. So using this, I have experience with this. We actually, in the beginning, we don't have this filter. Well, the machine will have problems, especially when you have high current TIG welder. Besides, the noise will affect the working status of the laser. Well, then we put on this, cost like $100, not very expensive, but again, it's a cost. Well, this machine doesn't have this, so probably you will have the disturbance of the current when the current is not very stable. And the last part, I think, is very unbelievable, is that they didn't wire in the chiller alarm circuit. Well, in this one, it has a chiller alarms circuit, which means, because for the welding gun and the laser source, they use the same cooling circuit, means that the chiller, if you open it in summer, you set the temperature at 25, for example, so the water will go to the welding gun and also goes to the laser. Well, probably when you, during the operation, if the mold function, that the protective lens becomes dirty, and then when the laser shoot on the protective lens, the lens will heating up. Well, when the lens heating up, actually, you should have the alarms from the CNC, from the control board, because they don't have this circuit, so you don't have the alarms. So your operator need to feeling the temperature of the gun. Sometimes they doesn't care about this, or temperature keep going up. You probably burn the focus lens and collimating lens. Then the QPH crystal burned, or the resonator burned. In this case, the machine is gone, because there's no way for you to repair, because the whole laser has broken, you need cleaver splicing, and it's just a nightmare. If that happened, you lost the whole machine. So this one looks very small, but very expensive, very important for the machine. I really don't understand why they just put it here. So the last part is the output of these pipes, wirings. Well, here is nothing, only this one protected. Actually, here should have the same similar protectives, and doesn't have the, the grounding wire is here, only with the gun, but the whole machine, the main switch doesn't have the grounding. Well, this machine, much nicer. Every wiring has the protective, even the gas in has the copper protective. So I have to say that this one looks bigger. The only advantage for this one is smaller, but this one in every details much more decent. Okay, so today we finished almost the comparison in very much details about these two machines. Same configuration, same laser, same welding gun, and same chiller, same looking, but very different. We compare from the overall configuration mechanical part and then the electrical circuits, wirings, and all the other details, things. So now I'm sure that as an end user, 100% sure you don't want this machine because you don't need to save that $500 or $1,000 to buy such a machine. You know, probably cost you big trouble after one month or 2 months because they look similar. And then you see the videos, they're welding. So yeah, as when the time you're purchasing, there is not much difference. But the difference coming from the hours of using of this machine, it's a tool. You need to use it probably 24 hours for years. So I'm pretty sure that nobody wants to buy such a machine, you know, for no matter even 2,000 less, you don't need this. Okay, so much for today. Hope this video can help you for choosing the right laser welders for you. And in the past years, we keep working on videos on how to choose or how to use laser cutting, laser welding, and laser cleaning machines. If you need these parameters or welding data or cleaning data, you can send me message or write emails to me. We'll keep working on this direction. Thank you for watching and thank you for subscribing to my channel. Bye bye. See you next time.